Hello friends, and welcome to this tutorial where we will learn how to upload GSTR1 online in MARG Erp through KARVY GSP panel. Firstly, ensure that your MARG Erp software is updated with the latest series C version, which can be downloaded with the help of our MARG website. And also ensure that latest GST patch is in your MARG folder. The latest GST patch can be downloaded from margcompusoft.com. Before filing GSTR1, you must ensure that there are no errors in any of your invoices. In MARG Erp software, there is a feature under Internal Audit option through which the software will indicate all the errors which exist in your invoices. In order to correct the errors in the invoices, you will go to Masters, Ease of GST Adoption, and then click on Item GST Percentage, then enter on Accept. Here you will press F8 function key in order to find unmatched items. With the help of this, all the tax mismatch items will get filtered. Suppose this is an item whose HSN you have already set. Here it is showing that there is a mismatch in the tax percent of this particular item and the tax percent of item in the item master. In order to correct, you will press enter and you will correct this. So in this way, after correcting all the tax percent and the HSN code of the items, you will go to final reports, internal audit, internal audit GSTR mismatch. Then you will specify the dates from which date till which date you need to see the invoices that contain errors. So a list of all the invoices will get open that contain errors. At the side of the software, you can see the type of errors which are there in the invoices. First type of error is ignorable errors. This type of errors can be ignored. Second type of error is correct with resaving. This means that you need to just simply resave those invoices that contains errors as specified here. The errors in the invoices will automatically get corrected once resaved. Next is manual correction required. These are those errors which need to be corrected manually. If you need to see the details, that is how you will correct these errors, then for that you will press F9 function key. On pressing F9 function key, the software displays the description of the errors and also shows that how to solve that particular error, which is indicated with purple color. In order to go back, press F9 function key. If you want to remove those invoices from this list in which ignorable errors exist, then you will press delete key. Then enter on ignorable errors here. If you will enter on delete single record, then only that particular invoice gets deleted, which is currently being selected. And if you will enter on delete same errors, then the error on the invoice which is correctly selected, then all the invoices with those errors will get deleted. For now, we will delete all the ignorable errors by entering on delete ignorable errors. Now, correct with resaving and manual correction errors are left. In order to remove the correct with resaving errors, we will select all the invoices first with the help of asterisk key, then press F6 function key, and then enter on resave bills. So in this way, your bills will get resaved and the errors will also get corrected automatically. Now, only manual correction errors are left. These are those errors which needs to be corrected manually. For example, there are two bills whose tax mismatch exists in SGST and CGST. You can press F1 function key here and select that error so that both the bills gets displayed in front of you. And now you need to press enter on each bill and correct it separately. Now there was a tax mismatch error of SGST and CGST in this invoice. So in order to correct it, we will go down and then press page up key here. Then here for load tax type, we will select yes. Then we will save this. So for rest of the bills also, you will set yes for the tax type so that the tax mismatch error of SGST and CGST gets corrected. So in this way, you will correct all the manual correction error invoices. Then once again, you will now go to final reports, internal audit, internal audit GSTR mismatch. And if it shows that no mismatch found,
Here then it means that all your errors has been corrected and there is no error in any of your invoices. So you can now file your GSTR1.
Firstly, you will go to final reports and then enter on GST returns. Then enter on GSP KARVY. KARVY is one of the GSP through which your returns will be filed. You will be required to register yourself on KARVY website. If you want to register yourself on KARVY website through MARG software, then you will enter on sign up online. If you want to register through KARVY website, then you will enter on sign up from website. This is the website of KARVY. If you want, then you can fill your details here and register yourself. For now, we will register through MARG software only. In this window, you will fill your GST login details. After filling the details, you will enter on register. So in this way, you will get registered on KARVY website. So let's see how you will upload GSTR1 on KARVY website through MARG Erp software. For that, you will enter on GSTR1. Firstly, you will enter the period, that is from which date to which date you want to view the GST summary. Then enter on show button. So in this way, your GSTR1 will get generated according to the government format. Then click on upload online. After clicking on upload online, this window will appear. In this window, MARG is showing you which all invoices has been uploaded on KARVY website and which all invoices are still not uploaded. Due to errors in some invoices, the invoices has not been uploaded. For example, if you have made a bill of local, but the bill that is being generated is of central, or there is tax mismatch in the bill, or you have not entered the GSTIN number in the bill. So these types of errors you can see from here and can correct it in your invoices. If you want, then you can also generate the Excel sheet of this. So in this way, two Excel sheets has been generated in the GST return folder. That is, one is of success and second is of failure. Those invoices that have been uploaded on KARVY website that will successfully being shown in the sheet. And those invoices that have not been uploaded due to errors, then what will be shown in the failure sheet? You can see correct those invoices in MARG software by seeing in the failure sheet. And then again, click on upload online. So the invoices which have not been uploaded due to errors, then that would get uploaded on KARVY website. You can also see the list of errors by entering on GST difference list. So in this way, we have uploaded the invoices on KARVY panel through MARG software. Now, we will learn to upload GSTR1 from KARVY panel. After logging in KARVY panel, this dashboard will appear in front of you. You will enter on returns menu from the site menu. Then enter on GSTR option. Then you will choose the financial year and month here. That is, for which date of the month you need to upload the returns. Then enter on summary under GSTR1. Then for filing GSTR1, you will click on GSTR1 returns file. But for that, there is a requirement for e-sign. There are two options in e-sign. One is that we can use the digital signature, and second is that we can generate the EVC, and the EVC will appear on your registered email ID. Then you will enter that EVC. Then from here you will click on GSTR1. Then it will get connected with the GSTN server and the file will get uploaded. So friends, in this way we had learned how to upload GSTR1 on KARVY panel through MARG Erp software. You can follow the same process and you can also file GSTR2. Thanks for watching.